Hawaii's largest law enforcement agencies will soon be carrying firearms, new firearms. But one agency got a much better deal than the other. It's a move first uncovered by Always Investigating. And Gina Mangieri has tonight's follow-up. Gina?
Last year, I told you about HPD's transition to a new style of handgun and the limbo their old weapons were in at the time. Now, state sheriffs are replacing their stock, too, and I found out who got the best deal for your taxpayer money.
HPD is phasing out its Smith & Wessons for Glocks at a cost of more than $800,000 for 2,000 guns. That's about $409 a gun, which is the same price that Kauai County paid for 20 Glocks.
How does that strike you?
Well, you know, I don't know much about Glocks, so that's the first problem, is that maybe that's just what they cost. But there's nothing wrong with doing some market research and finding out, hey, if we buy in bulk, why don't we get a discount?
Contrast that per gun price with the gun swap happening at the sheriff's. The state awarded a $300,000 contract to replace their Smith & Wessons with two different models of Sig Sauer. And because they'll be getting a credit of about $160,000 for trading in their old guns, the out-of-pocket for 750 weapons is about $178 a gun. While the Sig Sauer is a slightly cheaper gun in the first place, the big difference in price for taxpayers is because of that exchange credit. So we wanted to know why one department got such a good deal. The state isn't taking credit for coming up with the idea of the exchange rebate. They say it's something the vendor pitched in its bid. HPD says it followed procurement rules too, but only one company put in a bid for its guns and couldn't get any credit for its old guns from Smith & Wesson since they went with a new vendor. Dealing with waste and leftovers is something the state's top buying authority wants to see thought of ahead of time on all future buys, no matter the product.
I want folks to think right up front, you know, this is what we're going to need now. Is it replacing something? You know, are we buying new? What can we do with the old? Can we leverage any of that part? You may consider, hey, we could save some money by taking these old products or items and selling them, or we could go donate them for a good cause.
With no exchange planned, HPD's old guns were in limbo for quite a while. American Samoa authorities had told me they hoped for a donation, but HPD says a new administration there doesn't want them after all. That left HPD with safety concerns about selling them for parts or even to existing officers, and so they've decided to destroy them, which HPD says comes with no added cost.
The state procurement office says an online wizard program will help state and local agencies think of and plan for what to do with old things as part of the request for bids. That program should be available as soon as the end of the year. Gina Mangieri, KHON 2 News.